The Leopard is one of the most versatile of all post-war tanks. When the war ended, German industry was in ruins, but its scientists were still largely intact. Whereas British, American, and Russian tank technology was tied to the past, the Germans were able to rebuild from scratch. Germany's experience of armored warfare was far more extensive than that of the wartime Allies, and they used the experiments and mistakes of both sides to come up with one of the most versatile of all post-war tanks. The Leopard 1 is of conventional design, with hull and chassis surmounted by a fully revolving turret. Like all modern tanks, it has an engine unit which can be removed and replaced in the field, saving invaluable battle time otherwise lost on maintenance. The transmission system is a similar module which can be changed quickly. Main ammunition stowage for 42 rounds of 105mm shells is at the front. The gun is the proven British L7, as fitted to so many other post-war AFVs. Further ready-use ammunition storage space is provided in the well-shaped turret. This also incorporates a coaxial and an anti-aircraft machine gun. The original Leo 1s had cast turrets, but after an interim period of adding on applique armor plates, these were eventually replaced by a welded design featuring spaced armor. The Leopard is very much of an all-rounder with high agility and good cross-country handling. After suitable preparations, Leo 1s can ford rivers up to 13 feet deep, the commander giving the driver instructions from the top of his wading trunk. This is not a new idea. Panzer IIIs were similarly equipped during the Second World War for the planned invasion of Britain, which never came off, although they did see valuable use later in Russia. Track guards provide extra protection against high explosive anti-tank rounds. Mud and snow grousers are routinely carried on the glacis plate and can replace the rubber track pads when required. The German army remembers the problems its tanks had during the Russian winters. Both commander and driver have passive light intensifiers, which enable them to see clearly by starlight without revealing their own presence to the enemy. Because it weighs only 40 tons, the Leopard 1's 830 horsepower engine gives it extraordinary agility at a top speed of over 40 miles per hour. Modern improvements to the fire control equipment, coordinated by a dual-axis mirror system, means that the tank's gunnery is as accurate by day as it is by night. A laser rangefinder is now also being retrofitted as standard, which improves the chances of a first-round hit. Although the Leopard's armor is only some 70 millimeters thick, its design gives excellent ballistic deflection properties. An overpressure NBC system gives the crew additional protection against air contamination. Leo 1s are also provided with smoke grenade launchers to provide rapid screening in the event of a surprise attack. Like several other post-war tanks, the Leopard was designed so that it could be adapted to a variety of other purposes. One is the Bergepanzer, an armored recovery vehicle with a powerful winch for hauling other stranded AFVs out of difficult situations. It also has a bulldozer blade and a crane, which is used in changing Leopard engine packs. The Bergepanzer normally carries a spare engine on its rear hull for just this purpose. The combat engineer version of Leopard is similar to the Bergepanzer, but instead of carrying a spare engine, has a retractable vertical earth-boring drill. It is also fitted with a dozer blade. One of the most impressive of Leopard variants is the Bieber. This is a vehicle which can lay a 66-foot bridge capable of carrying all NATO tanks except the weighty Challenger. It is unusual in that the bridge is extended horizontally rather than unfolding through 180 degrees. This helps conceal the vehicle from the enemy. With such a sound basic design, it comes as no surprise to learn that other requirements were foreseen and catered for early in the production program. One of these is a computerized simulator, which allows future Leopard tank drivers to learn their skills without wasting fuel and perhaps knocking down some irate farmer's barn by mistake. A tiny road wheel follows the driver's control movements over a miniaturized landscape, and pictures from a small TV camera on the road wheel show him where he is. This learning process was taken even further with the Leopard Trainer, a turretless tank with a glassed-in superstructure housing the driving instructor. The high cross-country mobility of the Leopard 1, coupled to impressive reliability, have resulted in widespread export success to Canada and Australia, as well as several European countries. The 105mm L7 gun is still one of the world's foremost tank busters, even though it has been overtaken by other, more powerful pieces.